I got a job.
Like I don't.
Oh, Eddie, look at that. You put a dent in my door.
That ain't a dent, that's a ding.
No, a ding is what you get on a game show for answering the question right. That is a dent.
Breaker 19, we got a two-car front and rear southbound on 35W.
Him dang in there. Sing down there, do that, do that. Who's going down there, boy? That's what you're going down there, do it. 45, 45.
Is somebody supposed to understand what you just said?
Nah. Supposed to confuse them, that way I can get to the scene first.
Brother, you're not getting out the driveway first with that piece of nostalgia.
Hey, don't go talking about Broncula. She might be old, but she like wine. She get better with time. Catch you on the rebound, baby. Come on, baby. Come on, girl. Worked on you all day. Today, I'm tired of you breaking down on this tablet.
Now that's a dent.
Hey, hold up, baby. I'm sorry. I mean it now.
Isn't it collecting funny bone? They just won't leave you alone while you're sitting inside your home.
Rooster, don't make me do this.
The tape's broken. Hey, you wanted to be on the air? Here's your big chance. The following is a test in the emergency broadcast system. The emergency broadcast system. You're rocking with the Rooster!
Don't you ever do that to me again.
Hey man, nobody said radio was easy. It's all about paying dues.
Well man, I'm about all tapped out.
Hey, I got a friend over at KLAP. He says the sports guy quit. You interested?
Hey, I do sports. I breathe sports. You know, back home, everybody used to confuse me with Ahmad Rashad. I just wish I could meet his wife.
Well, great, man. You get me an audition tape tomorrow, I'll get it to him.
Hey, thanks a lot, Rooster.
No problem. Hey, now you do me a favor. When that song runs out, hit tape deck number 2, or Rooster's got to lay an egg.
Ooh, wait! This is where you work at, baby?
Eddie, how did you find me?
Wasn't easy. I went to the radio station you said you worked at, and you wasn't there.
Then how did you find me?
Oh, there's 36 stations in the greater Kansas City area. 35 of them never heard of you.
Eddie, you know, this is a radio station, not a playground.
So you in charge of all this sophisticated stuff? Man, I didn't know you were so important.
Well, I don't like to brag.
Hey, man, what's this do?
Well, look, man, I appreciate the visit, but I gotta get to work.
Well, I understand. Because when I'm on my job, I'm all business, too. That hook's got to get on the car.
Eddie.
All right. You the man. Damn, you good.
Thank you. Why are you here anyway?
I need to borrow your car keys.
Oh, no. You cannot borrow my car.
I don't need your whole car, just the battery. See, the truck broke down, this old woman needs a jump. So I can take the battery, get on the bus, and be right back.
No, I need my battery.
I'll fix that dent in your car.
I thought it was a ding.
It was until I backed my truck into it.
What?
It was an accident, and the tires came off of it. You know what I'm saying? There's like 5 of us working on it right now. I hired like 5 other people to come in.
Eddie, come back here.
Just because you and his mother have been best friends all your lives does not mean I have to like living with him. Because he's a nut. He's always running off at the mouth about something.
Everybody wanna come down and get towed for free. Some old woman ain't got a car wanna get towed. Just get drug around. And Broccoli, why you wanna act up? Fred Safford's truck never did that to him. This ain't about nothing. Worthless. You know, I give you high octane fuel.
Yes, it would make sense if he was talking to me, but he was talking to his carburetor. All right, bye, Mom. All right, Chicago Bulls, it's me and you.
Hey, you ever notice that Fred Sanford's theme song never had no words to it? I'm gonna write something, man. What do you think about this? Fred Sanford. Fred Sanford had a son and a truck. And a son named Lamont.
Stop. Just stop.
All right, man, I know it ain't all that good. You know, I just wrote it. You know, but it's hard to rhyme Lamont. Now, Grady, I can work with that. Grady. Shady Grady,
Eddie, please, just quiet, all right? Man, I need you to be quiet. I got a guy down at KLAP who wants to hear my audition tape tomorrow.
Really?
Yes. See, this could be my big break. Thank you very much. Now, if the guy likes my tape, I might get a gig doing professional play-by-play. That way you could Grady, Haiti, Warren, Beatty all you want, but just chill. All
right.
Gotta watch the Bulls game.
The Bulls? That's my team, baby.
And it's a tip-off. The ball's out of bounds, and it's a timeout.
Man, you good. Look, it's Bill Fontaine, man. Turn it up.
Hey, Kansas City, you wanna make millions?
Hell yeah! With that kind of money, I can get a fleet of tow trucks that run.
I've seen this guy before. He's a big front.
Tonight, I'll be in your area giving a free seminar.
We're there.
We're not.
Everyone who attends will take home a set of steak knives, a color TV, or a trip to Florida.
Now, how do you take home a trip to Florida, huh? It's a scam.
Well, I'm going.
Well, if you leave now, you could probably get a really good seat.
Why you always dogging me, dog?
Donald Royal takes the ball up court, and he passes it, and it's stolen by Jordan.
Man, how can you watch this, man? This set is terrible.
Oh, no, it's fine.
No, it ain't.
Jordan takes the ball.
Me and my magic screwdriver can fix anything.
No, Eddie, leave it alone, man.
No, I can fix it, I'm telling you. All it need is two little turns. One.
No, move out the way.
Two. maybe it need just one.
You broke my TV.
Oh, man, why is it always about you? I could have been electrocuted.
That would have solved two problems.
Oh, dogging me again. Where you going?
I'm going to Kelly's. I gotta get this tape done.
Kelly's cool, the tips are great, customers are friendly.
Hi, Holly. Well, hello, Lisa.
Very friendly.
This is Malcolm. He's the reason why you were issued mace with your uniform.
Don't worry about Holly, she just wants to keep me for herself. What time do you get off of work, Lisa?
About 11.
11? You know, it's a coincidence because I'm not working at 11 tonight either.
Oh, wow. That is a coincidence.
Malcolm, pick up somebody your own size. Come on.
Hey, Mom. I'm sorry about your TV set, man, but I figured out a way I can get you a new one. Two words. Bill Fontaine.
Oh, no, four words. I don't think so.
Bill Fontaine's giving away free TVs.
And Dionne Warwick's really a psychic.
Dionne Warwick wasn't a psychic. Her friends was. She was a psychic. She knew her way to San Jose.
Hey, Kelly.
Well, my two favorite tenants. What'll you have? The usual? Free pretzels? Water back?
Would you just hand me the remote? I need to watch the game.
What's wrong with your TV? The magic screwdriver again? Well, that explains the power outage.
Ah, no, I could have fixed it. You know what I'm saying? With a roll of toilet paper and a Q-tip, I could have had it working in no time.
Yeah.
Anyway, Kelly, there's a game on TV I need to watch.
No. Sorry, guys. Tim doesn't want the TV on.
Who's Tim?
A paying customer.
I don't see no Tim. My boy need to make his audition tape.
No, you better make it somewhere else, guys. If Tim doesn't want it on, and don't touch his books, he's studying for a test, okay?
18th century English poetry.
Egghead.
Yeah. I got a poem, all right.
Uh-huh.
While bookworm Tim is in the john,
yeah.
Malcolm and Eddie are going to turn the TV on.
Hold on, check this one out. We gonna watch the bull shoot dribbling fast. And when that Tim show up, I'm gonna kick him. Woo, Tim! Whole lot of Tim.
So, Tim, sir, there's a Bulls game on TV.
No, fellas. I'm sorry. There'll be no TV today. I must study.
Study? Study what? He need to study how to get that pack of hot dogs off the back of his neck. Studying's good. Studying's gotta get your degree. Mine's a terrible thing.
Eddie, I gotta get this tape made before tomorrow.
You can and you will. We go down to Bill Fontaine.
No. Get off the Bill Fontaine train.
Guys, you know I love you like my own sons. And like I told them, either order something or get the hell out of here.
Hey, Kelly, maybe I can make my tape over at your place.
My place?
Yeah. You're here so we won't be bothering you.
Oh, you'll be bothering me.
2 Irish coffees, Carol?
Hey, Holly, let me ask you a question.
No, I don't want to go out with you, and yes, they're real.
Holly, why are you always playing me?
Malcolm, you don't need me. You have your other girls.
No, I don't. I've changed, girl. I'm changing now. You could change me.
Ah, there you go again.
Okay, Holly, listen. We can start out slow.
Okay. No.
Yeah, it looked like he was shaking to the left. Came down the lane, thought you was gonna go all the way. Play out! Rejected. Happens to the best of us.
You know, I wouldn't be in this bind if you didn't break my TV.
I know. I'm trying to figure out a way to get you a new one. Bill Fontaine's free seminar. Hey, who said that? My man done already said he don't want to hear nothing about no seminars, no Bill Fontaine, no TVs. You know anything about that wide back?
All right, Eddie, I'll go with you.
Ah, for real?
Yes.
Tonight?
Yes, tonight. I will go to the seminar with you tonight. But it's just to prove you wrong.
Man, I hope we don't win that free trip to Florida, man. You know what the humidity does to my hair. Woo-wee! There it is, baby. Look at that.
Didn't I give him that TV away?
Uh-huh. Whew, it's got that new TV smell. Smell it.
No, I'm not smelling a TV, Eddie.
Fresh as a baby's bottom. Smell it. Come on, smell it, man.
Ooh, it is nice.
Uh-huh. Hey, man, come on, sit down, man. I'm gonna hook you up with that TV. Hey, if anybody in here got their heart set on them steak knives and you get stuck with the TV, we willing to trade. My man Malcolm needs the TV to make his audition tape. Show some compassion. Come on, do your thing. Do the one Dennis gonna take the ball, went to the hole. Come on, show up.
Look, is this why you brought me here to embarrass me? You could do that at home. I'm out of here. I'm gone. I mean, there's nothing here that interests me. Except maybe them.
Boing, boing, man. I got my eye on that one.
hey. There's my man, Bill Fontaine. He living large.
Extra large.
Good evening and welcome.
Bill! Go ahead, Bill.
When you leave here tonight, you will be armed with the tools to attain personal wealth beyond your wildest dreams.
I know, that's right. Told you.
It's a setup.
Before we begin, I'd like you all to fill out the application, which Lola will pass out. Please include your $10 filing fee with your completed application.
Ah, $10 filing fee. I told you it's a joke. It's a scam, man. I'll take 5 of those. You know, you really hand out papers well.
Excuse me, Mr. Fontaine, about that $10 filing fee?
It will be refunded when you purchase my Roads to Riches videotapes.
Bill, your ad didn't say nothing about your Roads to Riches videotapes. I think you... Malcolm, I came here for a free seminar, and you're trying to sell us tapes and who knows what else. Yeah. Yeah.
Huh? There's one in every crowd, folks.
Let me tell you something, Dollar Bill. I work hard for my money, like everybody else in here. And before we go giving our money to a gas bag in a nice suit, we want to know what we're getting into.
That's right, dog.
All right. Yeah.
Sir, I'm afraid I'm going to have to ask you to leave.
Oh, no. Me and my friend aren't going anywhere.
Not until we get a free TV.
Yeah, that's right.
Oh, my goodness. If you think I'm giving you a free TV, you are sadly mistaken.
Well, you can give me that set of steak knives. Then we can talk about the TV. You got a phone call. Go ahead, girl. Now, if y'all really want to invest in the 90s, I got 2 words. Tow trucks. Yeah. Have you ever been pulled on the side of the road and wonder why nobody will come and pick you up? You'd be out there all night. Then the police will pick you up talking about you causing trouble.
Right.
Spend the night in jail. Some big fools after you all night. Right. Huh? Trying to caress and fond of you. That ever happened to you? Then you got to get Chris Darden as your attorney. And he ain't never there because he's with Marsha doing the hanky-tanky. Then that's why you need the tow trucks.
Chicago has the game well in hand as the Spurs bring the ball up court.
You said we wouldn't get our free TV.
Well, when you're right, baby, you're right.
Sure you're right. When you're right, you're right. You know that Bill Fontaine's a no good.
Gotta finish this tape. The pass is in to Avery Johnson. The ball's midcourt, and it's stolen by Michael.
That ain't Michael.
That is so, Michael.
Nah, it ain't.
How many guys who are totally bald with their tongues hanging out do you know play for the Bulls?
That ain't the Bulls. That's Atlanta.
Damn.
Yeah, this is great. Hey, man. Did you get the job?
Nah, man. They gave it to somebody who had more play-by-play experience.
Nah, that's all right. Because I got the hookup. Invest in the future.
Didn't you learn anything from Bill Fontaine?
Hey, man, this is different. You ready?
Do I have a choice?
Ostriches, worms, and bees.
You making fun of me?
Nah, really, man. I know this dude. His name is Matufu Nkosile McCleek. See, and he got them on his farm, man. They flying around, flying worms with honey. He making millions.
Good night.
Now, I'm telling you, man. Look, you go down there, you find them with the honey, they slithering around. Look, if that don't work, man, I got another one that's right here. $1,900 joke. Now, it's $5 for the premise, then another $5 for the punchline. Now, I called him, man. One of them, I got the premise part. Your mama's so fat. Give me $5 so I can get the end of it.
Hey, Holly, give me some booty.
How about you? Jurassic Park? The whole ride?
We could strip naked and make Jell-O sandwiches.
I want to know what I'm getting into. You got a phone call. It's OJ. Lady, shady, grady, I'm lady, shady, lady,
Eddie, please, just quiet.
Shaboing, boing, man.